If you look around you, you will probably find quite a few objects that are made from steel. From prehistory and the invention of blast furnaces to now, with the development of direct reduction iron, steel has come a long way in helping the Industrial Revolution. Historically, steel was difficult to make and was mostly used in the forgery of small items like knives, swords, and armor. But now, with the development of technology and equipment necessary for the production of steel, we can find steel products of all shapes and sizes around us.
Hello again and welcome to another edition of Bazaar. Ever wonder how steel is made, or where it comes from, or what it is used for? If you're interested, stick around, because today we will explore Iran's steel industry as we check out its activities in the domestic market. We will also take a sneak peek at Iran's steel industry activities on the global stage. So, let's open this metal gate.
Our steel journey began at South Kaveh Steel Company in southern Iran. This steel chain production complex was launched into operation in 2007. This steel company has a large facility. It sits on 170 hectares of land in the Persian Gulf Mining and Metal Industrial Special Economic Zone near Bandar Abbas Port in Hormozgan Province. The biggest accomplishment of this company has been to complete its steel production chain from mine to steel. This company is one of the larger producers of steel in Iran, with a share of 10% in the country's domestic steel market.
ما 1350 نفر نیرو در فاز یک و مدول‌های احیامون داشتیم که این رقم با نیروهای غیر مستقیم در حدود 10800 نفر بوده. با استارت فاز دوی فولادسازی و با جذب 650 نفر نیروی جدید که تماماً از نیروهای بومی منطقه هم با آزمون و گزینش استخدام میشن تعداد نیروهای مستقیممون به 2000 و نیروهای غیر مستقیممون به 16000 نفر میرسه.
The firm has a full chain production line for steel and it starts at its mines. As you might know, steel is made from iron ore. In fact, a very simple definition of steel is basically iron, which is alloyed with carbon. This company has its own mine nearby, but it also gets its iron ore from nearby mines in Fars and Yazd provinces. The iron ore is first mined from the ground. It is then smelted in furnaces and direct reduction iron processes to remove impurities.
پروژه فولادسازی ما در حقیقت که ظرفیت 1.5 میلیون تن داره شامل یک کوره EAF هست با ظرفیت تخلیه 120 تن یک کوره پاتیلی هست که همون ظرفیت 120 تنه یک خط ریختگری هست که در حقیقت 6 تا خط تولیدی بیلت دارن یک سیستم حمل مواد هست که در حقیقت به نام MSS شناخته شده است یک سیستم جمع‌آوری گرد و غبار رو داره به نام FES یه سیستم WTP داره که در حقیقت کارهای انتقال آب و کمپنسیشن ما رو انجام میده در حقیقت تریتمنت آب هم تو بخشی انجام میده
در سال 98 ما با تولید 1,519,000 تن آهن اسفنجی و 1,157,000 تن شمش بالای 97% ظرفیت اسمی کارخونه رو تولید کردیم که علارغم حالا بیماری کرونا با رعایت پروتکل‌های اعلامی از طرف وزارت بهداشت و تشکیل کمیته‌های مربوطه فروردین 98 هم تونستیم با 100,520 تن تولید شمش و 124 هزار تن اسفنجی این روند رو ادامه بدیم.
Now, iron is great on its own, but it is prone to oxidization, otherwise known as rust, and is not always powerful. When carbon is added, it becomes much more durable and can be used in a variety of applications. Iron ore is, therefore, essential for the production of steel, which in turn is essential in maintaining a strong industrial base. 98% of mined iron is used to make steel in Iran.
This company makes a few types of steel products. It can produce steel for general building structures and concrete reinforcement, all the way down to steel for wires and pipes. Also, this heavyweight steel producer is active in the stock market, which allows it to be more competitive in the domestic market. For such a large facility like this one, there are many necessities. For example, this steel producer is in close proximity to the power plant that generates the electricity for the entire complex. Also, it has two seawater desalination plants that supply its water. These desalination plants are important because making steel uses a lot of precious water. It might be interesting to know that a lot of the equipment and machinery necessary to run this steel production chain can be locally manufactured in Iran. The steel industry is pretty complex, which requires specialized manpower. Also, this company is committed to research and development. It cooperates with scientific research centers and knowledge-based companies for both specialized knowledge in production and equipment.
تو بخش مکانیکال 10000 تن ما تجهیز مکانیکی داشتیم که همه اینها در حقیقت تامینشون تو اوج تحریما انجام گرفت و عملیات نصبشون هم توسط شرکت‌های در حقیقت زیرمجموعه خود هالدینگ کاوه پارتس و بنیاد مستضعفان انجام گرفت. ما تو بخش ترانس‌های برقمون، ترانس‌های قدرتمون، در حقیقت ترانس‌های جریان 19 تا ترانس نصب کردیم که شامل ترانس کوره، شامل ترانس پست اصلیمون میشه که همه اینها تو سال 98 نصبشون انجام شد، راه اندازی شد و در حال حاضر در حال بهره برداری هستن.
در خصوص الزامات رعایت مسائل زیست محیطی، فولاد کاوه جنوب کیش به عنوان یک صنعت سبز همیشه پیشگام بوده، به صورتی که ما ایزوی 14001 رو الان به صورت 3 سال متوالیه که داریم روش کار میکنیم و گرفتیم اخذ کردیم و از طرفی بحث آلاینده ها تمامی مسائل آلاینده به شدت کنترل میشه به صورت پایش آنلاین توسط سازمان محیط زیست و خود مجموعه.
ایران is well known for its rich mineral reserves. These reserves provide raw material to industries across the country. According to the United States Geological Survey, Iran holds the world's 10th largest iron ore reserves. Currently, Iran enjoys 2.7 billion tons of proven iron ore reserves, which is just under 1% of the world's total reserves. The Chadar Malu, Golgohar, and Sangon mines are considered the largest iron ore mines in Iran.
Iran's iron ore production has remarkably picked up production pace and has been steadily growing in recent years. Last year, Iran produced over 39.5 million tons of iron ore concentrates in the first 10 months of its year alone. In 2019, the Ministry of Industries, Mining and Trade imposed a 20-25% duty on the export of unprocessed minerals, including iron ore. Last year, the country exported over 7.8 million tons of iron ore in the first 6 months alone. But why did Iran place export tariffs on raw minerals and materials, such as iron concentrates? One answer to this question is that while Iran has large quantities of raw material necessary for productions in other industries, the export value for raw material is relatively low. So, value added to raw material, more often than not, increases the value and profit margin of the product when exported.
Iron ore has come under the spotlight for new restrictive measures. This is because the government wants to prevent a shortage of iron ore necessary to feed its steel industries in the future. As a result, the domestic market has been given attention and priority when it comes to supplying raw material. Consequently, surplus products in the domestic market are left for exports. Iran's steel industry is one of the most productive and thriving markets in the country.
Given Iran's advantages in steel production, the steel industry and its complete value chain are considered one of the strategic industries for Iran's 2025 vision plan. According to the Economic 2025 vision, steelmaking capacities are expected to hit 55 million tons in the next 5 years. Iran produced 31.9 million tons of crude steel during 2019. This is in relation to 2018, with a production of nearly 24 million tons. Going off of the World Steel Association statistics, Iran became the world's 10th largest steel producer in 2018. In early May 2019, the Trump administration imposed new sanctions on Iran's metals and mineral sectors. As the US president had said, this was an attempt to choke off the country's largest non-petroleum-related sources of export revenue. On the surface, it might seem that these sanctions could deliver a heavy blow to Iran's economy. But on deeper inspection, this hasn't been the case. Iran exported 9.3 million tons of steel in 2018, making it the 16th biggest exporter ahead of Spain and the United States. In 2019, Iran's steel exports reached 10 million tons, with domestic production at 47 million tons. Companies such as this one have been exporting their steel products to countries of South Asia, Turkey and the UAE, among others.
ما سال 98 با فروش 101,174,000 تن شمش فولادی که 862 تن تولیدمون به کشورهای آسیای شرقی و اروپا و کشورهای حوزه خلیج فارس صادر شده و 312 تن به شرکت‌های داخلی در بورس کالا عرضه شده که کیفیت تولیدی شمش فولاد در کاوه جنوب کیش بالای 98% صادراتیه ولی برای تأمین نیاز داخلی حدود 312,000 تن به شرکت‌های نوردی داخل فروش داشت.
So, looking at these production and export statistics, one can see that there might have been a miscalculation on Washington's part with regard to its outcomes of the sanctions.
فولاد کاوه جنوب کیش طرح توسعه‌اش و که اصل قضیهش بس پروژه فولادسازی فاز دو میشه ظرفیتش تقریبا ظرفیت 1.2 میلیون تن ظرفیت مشابه فاز یک که در حقیقت حجم عمده کارش تو اوج تحریم‌ها انجام شده حالا وضعیتی که داشته تو شروع عملیاتش در حقیقت تو تحریم‌های مرحله اول آمریکا بود اوج در حقیقت اجرایی ما کارهای اجرایی ما تو تحریم‌های مرحله دوم آمریکا بوده
Steel has had a major influence on our lives. The cars we drive, the buildings we work in, the home in which we live, and countless other aspects in between. Steel is used in our electricity power line towers, natural gas pipelines, machines, tools, military weapons, and the list goes on. It is also a metal that can be recycled over and over again without loss of properties, and it happens to be the world's most important engineering and construction material.
The construction industry uses a large amount of steel. Buildings and infrastructure are some of the projects in this sector that consume the most amount of domestic steel in Iran. Then there is the automotive industry, which has the second largest consumption share. Going off of the World Steel Association statistics, 51% of the world's steel is used for buildings and infrastructure. The second biggest use is the mechanical equipment with 15%. This is followed by the auto manufacturing industry at 12%. The remainder is used in other various industries, such as home appliances.
Well, everyone, we've reached the exclusive part of the program where I pass the action over to my good colleague out there on the field. Take it away.
Trust is the foundation of every human relationship. In the past, when societies were small, people could build trust through interaction over the years. But today's world calls for a different form of discovering credibility. That's where credit scores come in handy. For more on today's topic, follow us. Doing business in Iran was relatively simple in the past. That's because people often lived in small communities and knew each other fairly well. But in today's world, different types of transactions take place among people who rarely know each other. And that's why having a third party who can verify their credit history can help tremendously. Can you tell us about your company?
شرکت اعتبار سنجی ایران متولی تأسیس سامانه ملی اعتبار سنجی در کشور. این شرکت سال 1385 با مشارکت همه بانک‌های کشور و چند از شرکت‌های بزرگ بیمه کشور تأسیس شده، تحت نظارت بانک مرکزی فعالیت می‌کنه، تابع قوانین و مقررات قانون مصوب مجلس داره، آیین‌نامه مصوب دولت داره و بر مبنای این ضوابط قانونی کشور برای همه شهروندان ایرانی کار اعتبار سنجی و محاسبه امتیاز اعتباری و گزارش اعتباری رو انجام میده.
Every company has a product, and the product of ICS is information. Information that can be shared upon the request of its owner with different entities and at a low price. Mr. Jalili, the company's CEO, says some 100,000 credit scores are released at the request of their owners to banks on any given day. But how are these credit scores used? What is a credit score and what are its applications?
ما هر جایی که مراجعه می‌کنیم و یک تعاملی می‌خوایم داشته باشیم، یه معامله انجام بدیم، یه وامی بگیریم، یه کاری انجام بدیم که طرف مقابل ما برای اینکه به ما اعتماد بکنه لازم داشته باشه که به گونه‌ای اهلیت اعتباری ما رو بسنجه، این اعتبار سنجی اونجا کاربرد داره. فعلا در حدی که تو ایران داره ازش استفاده میشه، توی نظام بانکی ما بانک‌ها وقتی میخوان وام بدن حتما اعتبار سنجی میکنن، گزارش مشتری رو میگیرن. بعضی از فروشگاه‌های کالای اینترنتی هم دارن ازش استفاده میکنن، میخوان یه کالایی رو اعتباری به مشتریشون بفروشن. حتی ممکن تو خرید و فروش و فروش ملک هم مثلا خریدار ملک اون زمانبندی که گذاشته شده که پولها رو پرداخت بکنه، این اصلا سوابق گذشته این نشون میده آدم خوشقولی یا بدقوله، خب اونجا هم قابل استفاده است.
Banks, for instance, may require their customers' credit score to check if they're qualified for a loan. The customers then contact the ICS, pay a small price, and have their credit score released to the bank. Aside from being confidential, the ICS reports have other important characteristics as well. What are some characteristics of the ICS credit assessment?
یکی از مسائلی که به صورت منطقی توی ارزیابی اعتباری مورد توجه قرار میگیره، پیشینه اعتباری یک فرده. یکی دیگه از ویژگی‌ها این که ما برامون فرق نمی‌کنه اهلیت اعتباری چه یه شخص حقیقی چه یه شخص حقوقی، یعنی شرکت هم همینطوری‌ان. از دیگر ویژگی‌هاش به عنوان مثال این هیستوری یا تاریخچه باز پرداخت هر فرد طبق استاندارد بین‌المللی میگن باید بیش از 2 سال تاریخچه رو ما توی اعتبار سنجی به کار ببریم. خب ما الان تاریخچه اعتبار سنجی 10 ساله ایرانی ها رو داریم. یا اینکه یکی دیگه از ویژگی‌هایی که تو دنیا براش خیلی اهمیت قائلن اینه که سامانه‌های اعتبار سنجی به خود مردم هم اجازه بدن که گزارش خودشونو بگیرن. یه ویژگی خیلی مهمی این سامانه اعتبار سنجی داره، اونم حفظ محرمانگی اطلاعات مردمه. یک شهروندی وقتی به بانک مراجعه میکنه، بانک قبل از اینکه به این سامانه اعتبار سنجی بتونه متصل بشه و این فرد رو اعتبار سنجی بکنه، حتما قبلش باید یه فرمی رو در اختیار این فرد قرار بده، ازش رضایت بگیره.
Every year, the World Bank publishes a report of business regulations and their enforcement in different countries. One important measure in this report is Getting Ready, which contains 8 different criteria. And Iran's score in Getting Ready is 8, the highest score possible to attain. Some 40 million Iranians already have reports of their credit scores on the ICS and can request for its release to different entities. What are some entities that observe the function of Iran credit scoring?
یه مرجع نظارتی عالی ما داریم، یه شورای متشکل از نمایندگان وزارتخانه‌های مهم، وزارت اقتصاد، وزارت دادگستری، بانک مرکزی، سازمان مدیریت و برنامه‌ریزی کشور که زیر مجموعه ریاست جمهوریه، و این شورای عالی یک دبیرخانه ای داره که این دبیرخانه در بانک مرکزی جمهوری اسلامی ایران مستقره و اون دیگه نظارت مستقیم داره.
In the past, Iranians would build credits through building relationships. And so it will take a while before they're ready to take full advantage of the ICS. That's why an important part of ICS's job is to educate people about this new form of credit culture. So what's your outlook for the future?
ما هدف گذاری ایدئال و آیندهمون اینه که انشالله به این مرحله برسیم که به محض اینکه یکی میخواد خودش رو به دیگری معرفی بکنه، اعتبار سنجی خودش رو نشون بده. و نکته آخر این که هر چقدر ما اطلاعات سامانه اعتبار سنجی رو بیشتر بکنیم، وسیع‌تر بکنیم، رتبه اعتباری که در مورد یک شهروند محاسبه میکنیم دقیق‌تر میشه.
Checking the credit scores of individuals can also help prevent financial corruption through verifying the accountability of applicants. Thanks to ICS, in every transaction, entities can trust but verify. Whether in the past or in the future, your credit has always mattered and will always matter. So if you're looking to purchase installments, get a loan, or rent a house, building a high credit is the way to score.
Great report, many thanks. Now let's turn our attention to some news and trends in the metals and minerals industry of Iran, starting with a short review of the stock market. Iran's steel production registered the world's third largest growth last year. This is of course an interesting feat considering the sanctions imposed on some of Iran's minerals and metals companies. So with such an increase, the Iranian stock market for steel also showed huge growth. Impressive indeed.
This month, the main index shares of Tehran Stock Exchange were beyond 1 million points for the first time. This brought record-breaking highs when the benchmark doubled since the coronavirus outbreak in Iran. Some of the biggest contributors to this record high were from industrial, mineral, and petrochemical stocks, such as those from heavyweight steel and iron companies. Last year, the stock exchange also saw a lot of growth, especially from the steel and iron industries.
This year has been labeled the year for the leap in production by leader of the Islamic Revolution, Ayatollah Ali Khamenei. So for the already booming steel industry in Iran, this also means a leap in current production levels. The government has seen great potentials in further developing its steel business.
This is in addition to the government's 2025 vision plan for further growth of the steel market, both nationally and internationally. As part of the 20-year vision plan, Iran aims to become the world's seventh largest steel maker. Statistics released from the Iron Ore Association of Iran show that Iran currently has the capacity to produce 30 million tons of steel.
A recent trend among steel companies in Iran has been the competition to support the indigenization of parts and equipment for productions. This is an important step for many companies as they assess their future productions and obstacles. Firms are trying to find ways to cooperate with knowledge-based companies and research institutions to make these goals happen.
Localizing the technology for manufacturing products is a major economic approach for the country in order to achieve self-reliance. Domestically manufacturing equipment and machinery is crucial for reducing dependence on foreign sources and expensive imports. It might be interesting to know that the Minister of Industry, Mining and Trade has stated that Iran has achieved self-reliance in steel production. So with production being addressed, now attention is turned to the equipment and machinery necessary for production. The Minister of Industry stated that there are 3,500 equipment and machinery manufacturing units in the country. Over 2,000 industrial equipment and machinery have been listed to be locally produced.
Well, everyone, we have reached the end of today's bazaar. Don't forget to check out our Instagram and leave us a comment. Give us your take on what we covered in this edition of the program, because we would love to hear more from you. I'm Samson Sees. See you in the next bazaar.